In this video, we're going to go over the find and search functions in Excel. Now, these functions are used to identify the numerical position of a given character within a cell. And they're often used interchangeably. They can be. There's some cases where that's not the case. And they'll also can often be found inside other formulas where you need to know the cell position. So like if you're looking to extract data using left, right, or mid, these are formulas you can use for that. So we have our examples here. The first one is some product numbers with dashes. And let's say I want to know where that first dash is. So the basic find formula is equals find the text that you want. We want to put the dash in quotation marks because it's not a number. And then within the text, that means just the cell number. And we close our parentheses and we know that that first dash is in position 4. And if we want to find the second dash, we do the exact same thing, except we type it twice. So then after you're done, instead of your close parentheses, do a comma, find again. And then now you would do the dash again, B5. When you close your parentheses, you're going to add a plus 1 at the end and close that parentheses. This is so Excel knows where to start looking. So it identifies that it needs the second dash, not the first. So this lets us know that the second dash is in position 7. Now, if you had just left this out altogether, it again defaults to the first dash, and it thinks it's in position 4. So we don't want that. So we'll undo that. Now, if we want to do it a third time, we would just type this just like we had. So actually, we'll copy this over. And what we'll do here, instead of the closed parentheses, we'll type find again. Type this a third time. And we'll do plus 1, close that parentheses, and then plus 2, close that parentheses. And it lets us know that that third dash is in position 11. Now, the reason I wanted to bring it out a third time is you can just as easily leave this as plus 1, and it still knows you're looking for the third position. However, in the spirit of not losing your place, especially if you're working with a cell that has a lot of data, I like to just number them 1, 2, 3, and so on, just so I can see more of what's happening within my formula and not get lost if I have to go back and make a correction. So this is a situation where the formulas can actually be used interchangeably. Now, all I did was copy down my find formulas, and now it's referencing cell B7. And we're going to just replace the find with the search formulas, just find, replace with search, replace all. And this and you see that the result is still the same. So this is a situation where it can be used interchangeably. Now, one key difference is that the find function is case sensitive where the search is not. So for example, let's say we need to find the position of the letter R. So we can do equals find. And again, it would have to be in quotation marks. And where we want to look for it is here. And now it thinks that it's in position 19, which we know it's not. It can't be. It's pretty early on. So if we change this lowercase r to an uppercase R, you see that now it's referencing, it's letting us know that it's in the 8th position. Now, if you were to use the search function, it doesn't matter. You could just type your lowercase r, choose your cell, and it knows it's in the 8th position. Now, one other thing you can do is, for example, let's say you want to know where the word hurry begins. Now, in either one, obviously case sensitive again, you can type equals find and type the entire word that you need into your field. And you see how it flags that the word hurry as starting in position 17. So anyway, these are some ways that you could use the find and search functions. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please make sure to subscribe to my channel. There will be more videos coming very soon, and you don't want to miss those. So please do subscribe, and thank you for watching.